Now you listen to me real good. I've told you once, I said it 1,000 times. You get out of those pagan, satanic, religious, Christian churches. Christians do not follow the commandments of the Bible. Christians do what they want to do. They make up their own laws, their own rules, and their own regulations. Come out of her, my people, and come out from among them. And it's real simple and easy to ascertain who are these people you need to come out from. Easy. Number one, if they keep Sunday, that's an automatic sign that you need to not have any fellowship with these commandment-breaking, wicked deceivers and seducers and bewitchers of the truth. Simple.
All right, glory to the King. Abba Yah, we do thank you for all things. You alone are worthy of all praise, glory, and honor. We thank you for the redemption. We thank you for writing our names down in the Lamb's Book of Life, always being mindful of the sacrifice of Yeshua. We need your help, not only this Sabbath, but every single day, for every step that we take and every breath that we breathe. We thank you for our salvation. Speak to us your words of truth. Help those who don't have ears to hear and those who are ordained to eternal life. Give them that burning desire, Father. And once they receive it, help them to continue to keep putting fire to it. We bless you for all things magnificent. Name Yahshua. Hallelujah. You may be seated. You do know that you can have either as little or as much of the Father as you want. That went right over your head, didn't it? You can have either as little or as much of the Father as you want. Usually when people are depressed, cast down, sad, bitter, angry, frustrated, that's when you have went into self-absorbing. You left the Father because, and it's all about you now. Some of the greatest worship there is you. Things don't go your way, you stop serving the Father. You get corrected, stop serving the Father. Get rebuked, stop serving the Father. Oh, you're serving, but you're not serving the Father. You're serving the Father, which is you. You start to go into yourself. You can't tell me in that condition that you have the joy of Yah, which is your strength. You found out who your Yah was, didn't you? You know, the Bible says, watch this. Blessed are those which hunger. The full soul loatheth the honeycomb. See the reason why you're not hungry? Because you're full. America make your flesh real full. No wonder the Bible says better is that a little that a man has. But see, you got to have a lot to fill that flesh up, though, in order to make you feel better. Look at him looking at me. Ain't we about to ask backwards in this society? We do everything backwards. We think backwards. Our emotions are backwards. Our feelings are backwards. Our attitude is backwards. If Yah says up, we say down. He say left, we say right. We rejoice when we should be mourning. We mourn when we should be rejoicing. And then we think we're clothed and in our right mind. And then the insult comes when a preacher comes up here and tells you you're not who you think you are. Now, you're Israel. But when we say you're not who you think you are, you're not who you think you are with this high, lofty opinion that you have of yourself that nobody else shares. Because you've got a way. Ain't it always right? Yeah, it does. Yeah, seems that way. Don't it? Bro, saying get Ecclesiastes chapter 7. Not Ecclesiasticus and the Apocrypha, but Ecclesiastes chapter 7. Show you how contrary we are. And that's why it's hard for us to understand. See, because if you don't hide Yah's word in your heart, you're going to keep on sinning. And you don't call bitterness sin. You call it a negative emotion. That's why you don't repent. That's why you stay the same way. You know all of you are smarter than I am. You know that, right? I remain humble so I can be smart. When you're smart, you can't hear nothing from nobody. You can't receive instruction because you are the instruction. You can't receive wisdom because nobody has more wisdom than you do. So that's backwards. Isn't that backwards? That's totally backwards. The scripture says better is the day of one's death than of one's birth. Huh? But yet still, nobody is trying to die. And when death comes to our door, we try to cling to every breath possible. We're not dying spiritually the way we should. Hurts too bad. Hurts too bad for me to let Yah come in and be my master over my life when I can do it myself. Are y'all here?
Yes, sir.
Somebody is born. Oh, hallelujah. Glory to the King. Hold up. Who's going to start weeping between the porch and the altar? Look at them looking. Well, if you ain't going to believe the preacher, you won't believe the writings. Jesus said, you got Moses and the prophets. Now, the Moses and the prophets had already got. So what he was saying, you believe what their writings say. Believe their words and do them. Read, Brother Shane, listen to the book.
A good name is better than a precious ointment.
Y'all hear that? And that's why you think everybody has got this influx of changing their name. Because they're spiritual. They believe that if they come up and give themselves a name, that that's going to make them this super spiritual Israelite. And we name ourselves for what we want to be, but we can't attain it because we forget the next part. Read.
And the day of death, then the day of one's birth.
Now, ain't that backwards? You mean to tell me it's better the day of one's death than one's birth? You don't think like that? Y'all ain't all up on the ends and excited like you are when death comes. Come on.
It's hard to flip that mind, isn't it? Isn't it? Told you we think backwards. Paul also gave the instruction, said that we die daily. Let's say some of us. Some of us die daily. Some of us ain't dying at all. So wisdom says, better is the day of one's death than one's birth.
Yes.
So we live here in the natural. We're supposed to be dying to ourselves and alive to Yah, and we're not practicing dying. No. Why do you think you have all these emotions and feelings? When somebody passes on, you go to a mourning fest, a regret fest. Anytime the saints go home, it's always a celebration.
It is. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
If somebody bad passes, you don't miss them. If anything, you feel sorry for them. Read on.
It is better to go to the house of mourning.
And what do you want to do? You want to go rejoice. So you get into too much foolishness and frivolity, you lose sense of yourself. See where you can't understand this? Because if you're not practicing dying daily, there's no way you can understand these writings. You'll never get it. Because you've got a way that you view and see things. See, you think about it. This is very offensive to us even when we hear it. And it's offensive to us because we know how contrary we are to it. You're a bunch of hypocrites. Oh, you can acknowledge the truth when you hear the word, but when it comes down to living it, you're so far from it. Yeah, you are. See, you think yourself something when you are nothing. And that's why you're deceived. And the first thing flesh does, who he think he is talking to me like that? Someone that loves you more than you hate yourself? You don't even know how to love. The only love you know giving is giving bitterness. Giving hatred. You think about how much mess you done sold in this life. Now weigh that to how much good you've done. You done found out who you are. There ain't a man or woman that's not walking on this earth that's not self-focused, self-centered, and self-absorbed. The majority of everything you do is for you and what you call your own. You do very little for others. That's why your life is nothing but a bitter fest. Because you haven't got the principles. You don't even get joy for doing others because you always want to be on the receiving end. I listened to a brother this morning, one that we know. He used to go out there to Shofar Mountain and stuff. He done come up with a brand new doctrine. He said, we in the kingdom age now. I go, damn, what did I miss? So I shot him a few questions just to see where his mind's going. Huh? Said all the Bible prophecies have been fulfilled. I go, boy, I did miss it. Now, in order to come up with something like that, you got to do away with two-thirds of the Bible. This is called being vainly puffed up. Some of you study until you get mad. You smite yourself with madness, but you won't smite yourself with death. See, the reason why, anytime you get all excited and you get all bitter and you all in an angry, emotional frenzy, they let you know you're not dead. But you smart. Y'all remember the debate I had with that pig Roberts? You got more upset than I did at the person who insults. You know the reason why I didn't take it personally? Because ain't none of them true. Didn't bother me none. I knew what he intended to do. You feel sting from rebuke, it's truth. I'm going to leave y'all alone this morning. Y'all here, but y'all mind ain't here. Are y'all just looking dumb, or are you working at it? If it was true, then I'd kick. You have got to rise to a level of maturity. You take everything personally that shouldn't be taken personally. Anything you should take personal, you don't. The reason why you're concerned if somebody misrepresents you or lie on you because you're concerned about how others view you. See, when you see me demonstrate stuff like that, you can tell that my words, I mean what I say. I don't care what people think about me. We don't serve people, we serve the Father. See, you're still alive, ain't you? Got a portion of you still ain't dead. Father started right off. Better days of one's death than one's birth. And ain't nobody trying to die except a few people. Paul even viewed it differently. He said, man, I got a desire to depart and to be with the master. Ain't none of you saying that. You know the reason why you ain't saying that? Because you're still full of sin. You know you ain't ready. You can lie all day long and you know you ain't ready. The only way a man can talk like that is if he's finished his course. I wish I could say I was like Paul, but the Father give me an ultimatum. You going to stay here a little while longer and preach to these rebels? Deal with all this heartache and pain? Or you going to come on home? How long do you think it's going to take me to think on that one? Mm-mm-mm. So I told you, we may read it, but we don't meditate on his word, though, do we? Don't meditate on it at all. Majority of the apostles died horrific deaths. You know the reason why they died horrific deaths? Because the world was going to show them how much they hated them. You know who killed them? Their own people. Who did what? Think just like the world. When you get most offended at me, when I hit the world in you? Mm-mm. I say it again. I'm always right until I get to you. Y'all ain't seen what's all done taking place this dead season? We got a pastor that's been put out and an elder that don't even show up no more. Open rebuke is better than?
Secret love.
So much for that then. Got to rewrite that scripture, don't we? Isn't the gospel proud of not being ashamed?
Come on.
Oh, boy. You can tell that people just talk a lot of shit. They don't live a damn thing, though. They don't even believe what they say. See, I'm not going to have people. I deal with people for a while, but I'm not going to have people sitting up here standing before you presenting themselves that they something when I know they full of shit. Especially when they visitation come. People who believe they can correct and reprove and rebuke you, but they can't be corrected, reproved, and rebuked. It's a whole lot more easy being a brother and sister than it is being a leader under my watch.
True.
You people don't know because you're not elders and you're not teachers and pastors.
True.
Oh, I love them, but ask them if I play with them. Now, I'm compassionate the whole nine yards, but I will get in their ass.
Come on.
You know the reason why? Because we can't have hypocritical examples stage playing in front of you. Because if that's the case, next thing you know, you're going to live on stage playing because you're going to see an elder or a teacher or a pastor do something a certain way. You're going to think you can do the same thing.
Yes, sir. Right.
So he's taking it up on his own, Elder Spinning. He ain't been here in a month. And I give you this ultimatum. Don't you bring your ass back here for 6 months. And if you don't come at the 6 month, don't come ever again. How would that be if I sit up here reproving and rebuking, and then when it comes time for me to get rebuked and reproved, I turn away and run from it? Read the book, Bro Shane.
It is better to go to the house of mourning than to go to the house of feasting.
We're in the house of mourning now. Bible says it's better for you to be here now. What is this attitude when we run dirty, get caught, get judged, then we kick the traces? In our own little way. And think that we can come back anytime we want. Somebody say pride.
Pride.
What does pride always come for?
Destruction.
And the Holy Spirit always coming for what?
Fall.
Even warriors in the day. If they was on the battlefield and they knew they was done, man, they take the dignity to fall on the sword. There ain't nobody ever experienced more shame than Jesus Christ. The Bible said he endured the cross and he despised the shame. And the reason why he despised the shame, because of the glory that was set before him. See, you want to be loved your way.
Yes.
I don't want no part of that family coming through these gates. Y'all hear me?
Yes, sir.
If I let that spirit permeate in here, next thing you know, you all be hypocrites. And the one thing this generation has done lost is the fear of Yah. Read, Brother Shane. Well, what went on, Pastor Dow? None of your business. Save yourselves. You seen how we had to do with Tatum. And the only thing that could shut him up is when we used his own words. Yes. Until then, he was arrogant, boastful, proud, kept making videos, everything, didn't he? Y'all see what's taking place, right? Let somebody leave lying on the ministry and see what I do. I'm going to cross your eyes with truth. I'm going to expose you. Can you imagine how much love I exercised over the years by covering up a lot of these people that go out and cut a damn fool?
Yes.
And now all of a sudden, you go out there and you run to social media and all this stuff and see what I do to you.
Yes.
How's Suki doing now? We didn't get a response from them. You hear how confused he was? The devil, the devil, the devil, the devil, the devil, the devil.
Yeah.
You know what she said?
Yeah.
They would have you to think, and the devil put it in your mind.
Yeah.
How many of you single sisters would marry me if I went to a brother and said, she got a good spirit, but she ugly as a dog? I ain't going to say nothing. We're not concerned about it always. Flesh and blood ain't going to enter in, so.
Right. Hallelujah.
What kind of stuff is that? And you know what the sad part about all this is? The Bible, I'm going to paraphrase so you can understand it. All right? It says, man, if you can't stand before the judgment of man, how are you going to fare when the Most High Yah judges? And this is a very light and small thing. Sad, isn't it? Can't stand before the judgment of man, how are we going to make it with Yah? Read, Brother Shane.
For that is the end of all men, and the living will lay it to his heart. Sorrow is better than laughter.
What is better?
Sorrow.
You don't think that way. You don't think that way. You know the reason why sorrow is better than laughter? Because that's the only time the Father can get your attention. See, we got your attention this morning. Not because we were rejoicing. Hallelujah!
Come on. That's right.
Uh-oh. Look at them looking. See, you ain't never heard no preaching like this. But you say you read a book. We've been so used to these stage playing hypocrites, and they present it away to us that if any time somebody does not come our pre-programmed way. Brother Dan up in Minnesota, he said that he had took his family, wife and children, daughters, and they set them down in front of me and they listened to me, can't stand me. Well, you know why? Don't like the way I say it. Then he turns around and there's another brother over in Africa, very soft, real soft looking to the eyes, almost bored on a. And they could listen to him. Oh, and they love everything that he says. And Brother Dan says to them, he ain't said nothing no different than Pastor Dow.
Come on.
You people got a concept of Yah that is off the chain. Who do you think? You know, the Bible said it is a fearful and a what? When you see the Father, you think you're going to be, are you going to be on your knees, on your face, or are you going to be standing up? You better sober up. Even then, you better hope that he have mercy on you. You never heard the vision of the kingdom, huh?
No.
The Father sitting up there, and he says he got the sheep on his right hand and the goats on his left.
Yes.
And guess where they all at? In the kingdom. You know how many people are going to be sitting there thinking that they made it?
Yes.
Only to be thrust in the outer darkness where there shall be weeping and gnashing of teeth?
Yes.
See, the reason why he says he chose by the foolishness of preaching. You can read that Bible, but it doesn't bring the impact that his preaching does. See, the preaching give you an opportunity to despise Yah.
Come on. Preach.
Oh, no. We don't despise Yah. We just don't like the way you preach. All right, what lie have I told?
None.
Yeah, you do.
Right.
Everybody heard about Elijah, right?
Yeah.
Elijah would just pop up.
Come on.
And the first thing they would ask him, you come here to judge us? Are you here for conditions of peace? You just sashay and walk around.
Right.
See, America is a cancer on your spirit. It's a bad cancer. All this sloppy grace, all this deception. Don't know the Father. Let me see. When the Father came down on Mount Sinai, Israel wanted to see Yah. That's you. Wanted to talk to him. They washed for 3 days. Ceremonial cleansing. God, oh, man, we going to see Yah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. He shows up. All of a sudden, nobody wants to see Yah. Nobody only want to hear his voice. The voices of many waters.
Yes.
That's that same Jesus.
Yes. Same.
See what religion done? There's not a friend like the lowly Jesus. And the reason why you can't receive, behold the goodness and the severity. Reason why you have a false balance, because you have a concept in your mind the way you think he is. He even set borders and told Israel, don't come past these borders. When he showed up, he ain't got to worry about them come by them borders. They took off running, didn't they? Some of them begged, Moses, that's enough of that.
Yes.
That's enough of that. Why was Moses standing tall? Because he's a man of Yah? No, Yah had already been dealing with Moses before he even came to the mountain.
Yes.
Don't you think Moses was just sitting up there celebrating Yah without him first getting on his face?
Yes.
Yeah. In his presence is where I want to be. You sure of that?
Come on.
That's what Israel wanted to be.
Yes.
At least they thought they did.
Yes.
What was the problem? Sin.
Yes.
Hidden sin, iniquity, transgression makes no difference. What happens whenever the Father shows up around here? You can feel the Ruach usher in, and all of a sudden it's like people start getting terrified. All of a sudden, fear, whoo, comes over people.
Yes.
Don't it?
Yes.
And Yah starts speaking to us, and you still are shook in hours later.
Come on.
You know the reason why? Sin. No sin is going to glory in his presence. Sorry to tear down y'all concept of Yahweh. It's the only thing going to sober you up, though. That's the only thing going to sober you up. You see, we're increasing in knowledge each year. And ways we used to judge 5 years ago, we have to judge greater now. Why? Because too much is given. Much is what? Too much is given. Much is. So we can't judge the same way we used to when we in the inception of certain things. As we gain an increase in knowledge, of course, the Bible, I tell you, the more I learn, it seems like the more sorrowful I am. You learn, and you happy and excited. I'm learning. I experience pain and sorrow. You learn, you won't go run tell it. I learn, I say, woe is me. For I'm a man of unclean lips. And I am in the midst of an unclean people. When I learn, I begin to understand and see Yah for really who he is. And I go, how inadequate I am. Then that's why I can say, have mercy. Have mercy on me. Yeah, I be tripping out. Watching all these debate fests the brothers have during feast days. I can say, you can tell they ain't learned a damn thing. They ain't learned nothing. Bro, Charles is a man quiet by nature. He can be in the midst of people and you can recognize his quietness. He's just that way by nature. And the Bible says that that man is counted wise. A bunch around all you people love running your damn mouth. More recognizing you are and you want to run your lip. You know, young man, when you're sitting in the midst of elders, you know the best thing you do is put a right over your mouth and shut up. You don't learn nothing by asking questions. Because you always have another question for that question. And the reason why, because you're always looking for wiggle room. Until you can get something to satisfy what you've been looking for in the first place. I remember one time I was talking to a young man, and he asked me a question. I gave him the answer that he wanted. He said, oh, glory to the King. I said, did I tell you the truth? What do you mean? Did I tell you the truth? Well, yeah, I said, no, I didn't. See how deceived you are? See, I gave you what you wanted to hear, and you thought, yeah, I just got finished speaking. Now who the fool? Better go to the house of mourning. Yes. Read, Brother Shane. Boy, we done flipped y'all world upside down this morning, ain't you?
Hallelujah.
Huh? Y'all want to walk back out and come back in again? Start all over.
Come on, Pastor. Come on. Hallelujah.
When you come to the house of Yah, how are you supposed to come?
Come on. Yeah.
See, you do everything backwards. You ain't excited about coming to church. You're not excited about coming to assembly. You're supposed to have rejoicing in your hearts.
Yeah.
Ready. Like, told you. Don't get mad at me when I show you the real true you. Don't get mad at me. Then I got these brothers up there in the Pennsylvania. I got a priority mail letter from a brother up in Pennsylvania that don't have nothing to do with this situation. He wrote me 6 pages. First, you know, with all the greetings and all the humility and all the salutations and all this other stuff. Then he proceeded for 6 pages to tell me how I misjudgment. Me and the elders that are dealing with this. Brother been saved every bit of a year or two. Been walking, we are every bit of a year or two. Let me tell you something. Only time I ever miss something is when your wicked heart is indicted in doing something that you know you shouldn't be doing in the first place, but you're looking for approval so you can do it. The only reason why you ever concerned about somebody else's matter is when you have the same thing in your heart. And the only thing that's restraining you is the fear of Yah. Come on. You're just looking for sanctions to do the same exact thing. Yes. Come on. See how smart I am? Wisdom is the principal thing. Yes. It ain't a young man that's got a lick of wisdom. You know how I know that? I've been young. Yes. And now I'm old. And being young, serving the Father, and now I'm old, I can say I've never seen the righteous. I've seen the wicked. Because the wicked always forsake Yah. Yah don't forsake. Yah keeps his covenant. So how is his for all y'all Bible studying? Now you got to go back to the drawing board, don't you? Now you got to go back to the drawing board now. We read it that Yah don't see the way man sees. Man looks on the what? But Yah always looks on the what? And on the heart. And he always says, I'm going to judge the very thought. Hey, here's the key. This is what we never judge. That's what I always judge. The intent of a man's seen somebody years ago doing something with the wrong intent. But when I went up to him, rather than crawling all in him and rebuking him, I said, I just admonished him and said, brother, look at it like this. Oh, see, he had the right intent. But he didn't have the wisdom to bring the intent forth. And see, I got to be in a position to be able to judge that. Because some of you mavericks, I told that brother. You think rebuking is so easy? Oh, I know you don't, because you don't ever rebuke each other. If your brother trespasses against you, rebuke him. Yes. See, you never do that. You always wait for somebody else to do it, so you run for cover. Yes. Don't you, hypocrites? Yes. So you can be able to keep your relationship together. Never mind. See how smart you are. You wise, I speak as a fool. And even all this is for your edification, your exhortation, and your comfort. I told you, this country and this society has wired every single one of us. And the Bible teaches us that we need a hate the garment spotted by the flesh, and America spots your flesh real good. Yes. It spots it real good. Don't it? Yes. You don't hate it. Right. You'll never know how wicked this country is until you get outside of it. Yes. You get outside of this country, I promise you, you'll go to another country and look for the highest mountaintop so you can go repent. But then you'll see how wicked you are. See, in this country, wickedness is righteous. And righteous is wicked. Somebody called me a despicable preacher. Say, you are a disgusting and a despicable preacher. So you know what I did? I said, okay. Let's see who's talking. a faggot. As you judge, so shall you be judged. You know the reason why I was disgusting and despicable in their eyes? Because I had the arrogancy and the audacity to bring out the defilements of what these evil, wicked people do behind the scenes. Oh, I know what y'all do. I know. You go take a shower and clean your asshole out real good, so therefore you're not disgusting no more, right? See, you thought I was altogether like you. You thought I was vile. I would be even more vile to your sorry ass. See, stuff like this, this is what would get you put to death in this society. I'd be like Stephen, looking up. I see Jesus. While them faggot, nasty homosexual and lesbians stoning me.
Yep. Glory.
You can tell the way America going.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
People don't love, they don't even fear. Matter of fact, they ain't even no God no more. It's only Satan.
Yeah.
You know what the motto of Satan is, right? Do as thou wilt. What do you do? As you will.
Yep.
The arrogancy and audacity to sit and call me something nasty and despicable. And then when we see what you do, I see the reason why you're perverted. There ain't nothing more, no more nasty and despicable than that. See, if we don't talk like this, our children, with all the information that's out there on the information highway, it's worse than the TV. These boogers gonna get ideas. Unless they grow up in an environment where that lifestyle is condemned, thoughts they will entertain.
Yes, sir.
You ain't never listened to a song.
Come on.
And then 2 days later, out of the blue, out of nowhere, you're singing the lyrics to it.
Yes, sir.
You ain't never stop for a second and go, hold on.
Yes,
what is that? You try to cast it out and get out of your mind, won't go nowhere. Won't go nowhere. What do you think is going on with this society out there? I kissed a girl and I like it, and it's played over and over and over. Next thing you know, women are starting to look at women the way they should men. They're starting goo-gooing and everything, and then they get ideas, and then the spirits that is in them. Because they entered in through the ear gate. And the vain imaginations that is inside the minds. All of a sudden you start to reason. What's the difference in kissing her lips and kissing a boy's lip? Rationalizing. Next thing you know, you're locked up and you get a feeling. Ding! The devil just put a hook in your spirit. Now you can't even condemn it as unrighteousness because you feel love. If it's so wrong, why does it feel so good? Sin always feel good. Adultery gets you killed, but man, I bet that stuff feel good when you're doing it. What's wrong? Too holy and too sanctified for your wicked heart? It's still sex and it feel good. But it's unlawful. There's a law against it. That's what makes it sin. All sin feels good. Until it gets to its tipping point. It's got its hook in your jaw. And now it's starting to work death. And now you're bound. Because you entertained something you should have stayed away from.
Yes.
So when we preach here straightway, we're telling a straightway truth.
Hallelujah.
These children are going to know it is a defiled thing.
Yes.
for a man to be with a man and a woman with a woman kind. They're going to look at it with disdain. You look at society now. Gag order. You don't feel that spiritual gag order? One day I was out late getting some building material. I said, man, I'm going to go get something to eat. I went into a steakhouse, get something to eat. All the waitresses and wait, wall-to-wall faggots. Yeah. And that woman said, can I help you? I said, nope. You know what I went to? I went to Cracker Barrel and ate me a grade B steak. Why? Because I know I ain't got nothing but old grandmama coming up there. How you doing, son? Yeah. Hey, mama. I want to enjoy my meal. Yeah. Never mind. Never mind. See, this world has spiritual entities out. It's putting a gag order on your mind and your mouth. Forcing you to accept and comply with the satanic agenda. Renee, you in college? How many faggots up there? Too many. Too many. Don't you feel safe when you have your head covering on and dress on? Don't nobody approach you, do they? Nope, not at all. Now, I ask you, if Jesus went to that campus, who would he go to? See, nah, never mind. You don't get it. Yeah. I know what it is. You see that video I did with all them chemical trails, right? They done landed on top of your head. That's why I get that delayed response. Yeah, it's too late now. We done moved on. I'm sitting waiting on you and your lethargic mind to work. Y'all better start praying for this ministry because it's one of the last bastions of truth that there is in the world. You know, people just don't preach like this no more. Used to be, if you didn't leave a church feeling convicted, you didn't even go. See, my generation, this is an old dying breed right here. Old Elder Austin, he got it on him now. He'll tell you about yourself. You heard him preach. Oh, he got it now. That's a young man. Well, shall a young man cleanse his ways by taking heed to the word of Yah. Huh? They say, well, how in the world he come like that? By listening to me. Yes, sir. Hey, young man, 29 years old. 29 years old and more mature than you 40, 50, and 60-year-old fools. Yes, sir. If you should be ascribing and look to anybody, I could understand y'all younger generation, y'all teenagers and y'all 20s looking at me and say, well, that's kind of out of touch and out of reach because we wasn't there when you were serving y'all. Well, you got young people here now. Yes, they're serving y'all. Yes. You have an example in front of you, so what's your excuse now? Yes. I tell you what, you're wicked as hell. Yes. Y'all set up here surrounded by all these great cloud of witnesses. You tell me you can't live holy? Right. Come on. I started to walk in here this morning with my birthday suit on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Sister's been doing like this. It's supposed to be funny. It's called ha ha. Y'all never mind. What was it with Isaiah that he walked around all those years like that? He said, man, this is how wicked my people are. Sure, I think y'all ain't no prophet. Woo! Boy, them prophets be going through. Man, oh man. Boy. Woo, and people want to be, people think they want to be, man, y'all. I tell you what comes along with being a pastor. Despised, rejected, hated, mocked, scorned, derided, chided, ridiculed, rejected, betrayed. That's what comes with this calling. A very thankless job. Y'all always makes it tough. Always makes it tough for leaders. Y'all understand, Israel is a big old nation, but you only had a few people that really loved Moses. You only had just a few people that loved him. Jesus had 12 disciples that walked with him and ate with him and slept with him for 3.5 years. He warned him and told him what was getting ready to take place and stuff, and he says, you know what? You're going to forsake me. Yeah. Oh, no, I ain't. Okay. Tell you what, for the cock crow. Thrice. Nope, not me. What happened? The Father knew he was going to do that. That's why he deposits something into all of us called a Ruach. And boy, did Peter come back with a big old bang then, didn't he? Huh? He wasn't no more forsaken then, is he? You know why? Because he had a part of that same spirit that David had on him. He had what John the Baptist had on him. John the Baptist was born with the Ruach, but right when he came out of his mother's womb, he was full of it. He was filled with the Holy Spirit in his belly. Now look what kind of preacher he was. I know what your mind says. Oh, I love Pastor Dye. I just don't like the way he preached, and neither do you love John either. Look at him looking at him. You love preachers your way. Everybody got always something to say, but they can't preach. You know what preaching does? It gives you no place to run and hide. You get up and preach, you represent y'all, all eyes are going to be on you. Everything you do, the congregation is always watching. Even when they're not even watching, they're watching. You get to go run dirty. Then you cover up each other's dirt. See, the way you cover a multitude of sin is after you rebuke your brother and sister, and then you keep it between you. You see that they're walking in newness of life. If they ain't walking in newness of life, then you go run tell somebody. You see it. If somebody is sin, and you go, well, okay, I'm covering more to sin. I see no evil, hear no evil. You forget what Ezekiel said, don't you? Huh? When the righteous stops doing right and starts sinning, and you see it, and you don't want the righteous to get out of that wicked way, guess who is going to be responsible for the death of the righteous? You are. So much for your judgment. So much for you knowing it all. If you want the wicked, and the wicked turn from his wicked way, guess what you've done? You saved who? You? Oh, but see, your mind is, oh, I just saved them. No, you just got finished delivering yourself, hypocrite. Why you think y'all let you see certain things? Why you think you let me experience certain things when you and your little fellowships and everything? He's there to see, test you, and try you to see where your heart is. You got your little friends and all this, but you ain't a friend of y'all. Some of you had fellowship with wicked folks and never rebuked them. The only reason why you do that is because you're looking for the same wiggle room. And some of them done died in their iniquity and you still got blood on your hands. Because you was too busy worried about friendship rather than being a friend of Yah. Oh, never mind. Well, I thought we said we loved the Bible. I thought we loved the word of Yah. See, you don't see the way Yah sees. You be functioning and have no clue what's going on. You think covering the multitude of sin is not saying nothing when you see it. And let me give you the real skinny reason why you don't say nothing when you see it. Because you don't want nobody reproving you on your hidden sin. See, you rebuke a brother, and then if he can repent, the Bible says you have gained him. Yes. See, you ain't trying to gain nobody because you still dirty. Yes. And you're running dirty. Let me remind you of something. Yah's kingdom is holy. Yes. He's righteous. Hallelujah. And ain't no defiled thing is going into that holy kingdom. Yes. Keep living and breaking his commandments if you want to. Keep justifying yourself with the wicked people out in this world if you want to. I'll give you a sobering word. You got one time and one time only at this life. There's no redos. You better get it right now. Good. Now we're ready to receive the word. Now, ready to see the word now. Everybody sitting in that chair. Believe it or not, they used to have revivals at preaching like this. You know the reason why? Because they were living so righteous. Oh, boy. Glory to the King.
Look at him looking.